First, I would like to say my father, Professor Karski Wertz, who is absent today, and he is very apologized all of you that he couldn't come. And it is pity also that he will not present him his papers about his paper about ecology, but many elements will be present in next papers. Test in screening for chick exclusion prophylaxis of scoliosis, practical presentation. We have to remember that asymmetric movement of hips connection with seven contracture syndrome, which unfortunately will be presented at Thursday, influenced by functional problems, standing and ease on the right leg and functional by walking, I'll show you later. There's also additional causes connected with CNS and three groups and four types of scoliosis. This seven contracture syndrome will be presented on Tuesday, so Thursday, so I will only show that it is very important in newborn period that the child are usually a turn in one side, and but it is influences for next years and for all year, for all life. Some elements are similar by all children with scoliosis, like lack of movement of the spine, the hyperlordosis with flexion, contraction of the hips, and sometimes laxity of the joints. And I show you some tests which can explain this situation, how it's influenced. First, it is the very important, it is the range of movement of the hip joint. It is the movement which is tested in hyperextension. It is known as the Ober test. And this Ober test, it should be similar in both sides, and here you see the difference. This right leg has no adduction in hyperextension, the left leg has hyperabduction in adduction in the hyperextension. And the very important is the difference. It could be both contracted or both not contracted, and it leads to three kinds of scoliosis. And we see this test is more sensitive when the knee is flexion, when it's extension, in extension is not so sensitive. But every time we have to check the movement, and the right leg has a smaller movement. So again. And what happened? When we have a healthy child, the movement of the left and right side are similar and reach about 20-30 degrees. When we have the very big difference, very big possible adduction of the left hip and real contracture of the right hip, this difference lead to the S scoliosis, S-shaped scoliosis. We call it first epitopathological group. And this is connecting with gait and standing. Then we have a second group, which the difference isn't so big. We have also very big movement of the left hip, but the right hip is not so, it is not so contracted like in the first group, but it's still not the same range. This can lead to this C-shaped scoliosis or S-scoliosis with dominating lumbar left convex scoliosis. And then we have the situation when the both hips has contracture. It could be difference more or less, but both hips are contracted. And we call it is scoliosis without scoliosis. Only the most problem is the stiffness of the spine without movement, sometimes even lordotic deformation of the thoracic spine. And these children, these girls, these boys are coming to orthopedic surgery not because of scoliosis, but because of pain. It is painful. And other tests, the flexion contracture. It is many tests to show it, but this one is very clever. We ask patient to lie down on the stomach, and then when he or she flexes the knee, you see the pelvis moving up. The next test is the kneeing test. When we see the patient which is on the knee, it should be the straight position. And it is very sensitive test for the contracture of the rectus femoris muscle and other groups of flexors. It is some examples for this. It should be straight line. When these curves are bigger, it leads to bigger, it means it is bigger contracture, and we can call this situation like a moving wheel for the scoliosis. Another example, once more. The same you see here is on the lying position. The pelvis is moving up, it's lifting. And here is the kneeing test. It is known this front shifting of the pelvis also can lead the hyperlordosis and the dorsum rotundum also, but it is connecting with scoliosis. In the second, third group of scoliosis, it is no such a contracture, but it is straight, painful spine. The next test, it is Adams-Meyer test, which our modification. The first one, it is just bending test. I ask the patient to bend down, but when we add the bending to the side, then we see more difference. The other test is a standing test. Normally, patient with scoliosis has a lumbar scoliosis to the left. And when the boy is standing on the more on the right leg, the scoliosis increase. When he stay on the left leg, the scoliosis disappears. The next test, it is the rotation test, and it was mentioned already today, but as a effect of scoliosis. And here we can say that it is at the same time. It is coming, this child has no real deep scoliosis, and this asymmetry is already present. The sitting test. We remember that the parents or the teachers say to the pupils, sit correct, sit straight. But it is not good because it can lead to scoliosis. This rounded back is going to protect scoliosis. The next test it is to see the range of movement on the right leg when you try to cross legs during standing. And it is depends moment. When the right leg it is in front of the left one, the range of movement is bigger than it, when it is in the back from the left side. In conclusion, we can say that important proper diagnosis, important proper test, important first the adduction of the hip test, then standing test, and others. Many thanks for invitation. Thank you for attention. I will ask you to not make break for discussion because the next paper is the same tema and it is